The Queen's Gambit. We have been talking a lot about the Carlsbad structure, and today we're going to see one of the lines I have recommended here being busted. It's refuted, I think. I think there's problems for black, and I will have to search for a new line for black against the Carlsbad structure or the Queen's Gambit exchange variation. That is one of white's main openings. By the way, I hope the quality of this video is good, because we have had some technical problems recently, and well, I'm not a technical guy, so I hope it's fine. Otherwise, we'll have to get the technical people in and do something with the setup. So please give feedback on the technical aspects of this video. Is it sort of and is the sound okay and stuff like that? Anyway, it's been a little while. I have been on vacation. You can see I have a nice tan, or Valentine's tan, and also got a little bit of a cough due to, the air condition when you're sleeping in Sicily is bad for the throat, but without air condition, it's 35 degrees Celsius, and you're sweating like a pig, so it's not so easy to decide if you want to be ill or you want to not sleep due to rotating like some grilled chicken. Anyway, let's get into the game and see what's going on here. We have a Reiner Knaak with white against Mogens Thuesen. This game was played in the veteran or senior World Championship for teams, which was played in Italy, Aquiterme, very recently. Reiner Knaak, by the way, is an East German. Well, of course, now they're all West Germans, or they're all Germans. Grandmaster who also played for Porch at one point in the Bundesliga. And he's very famous for being the one who according to the team captain there, lost the championship again and was fired on the train back from the match. A very famous history in German Bundesliga. He's, by the way, a rather good player, and he's won some nice attacking games, so he's worth watching. In this game, he is white against Mogens Thuesen. I played Mogens a lot. He's a Danish player, around 21, 30, 50 or something. When he's playing well, he's much stronger than that, and when he's playing worse, he's much weaker than that. His bottom level is not good enough, but he can really play at a decent level. When I first qualified for the Danish Championship, I won a playoff match against Mogens Thuesen with 3-1. I lost the first game and won the next three. That was in 1991, so way back. Okay, this is the line we have been discussing, where black put the bishop on d6. Instead of sort of so he's trying to prove that he does not need to sidestep the pin, that he can somehow get rid of the pin without anything. And the bishop, of course, is much more active here. We can see here in this position, we have in an earlier video we saw that white played with knight e2, and there was a game where Moisenko lost in a horrible way. So that was, you can go back and see that in the Carlsbad structure. A great game by black. It was in a repertoire for black in the Carlsbad structure, I think, something like that. Anyway, knight f3, of course, is another way to play. Queen here, and due to the pin, white is already threatening here, but black's idea was always playing with this move, this way of defending h7, just attacking the bishop, and a5, which is also part of black's system, to go like this and get the knight into the game, and probably here, and maybe even something like there, or maybe here, we don't know yet. Knight a6, threatening to play knight b4, which would win the bishop pair, and this is white's good bishop, so he would not like that to happen. So a3 makes sense. Also, white is often preparing the minority attack with b4 to try and create a weakness on the queen side. But in general, white is much more interested in playing in Filsbury style with knight e5 and f4, but at the moment this is not easy due to this being covered by both the rook and the bishop. Here black plays bishop g4, threatening to take here. It's not completely clear that black would take on f3, and the computer actually suggests that you can play this move. But it also suggests this move and here and so on. Here with the bishop going back, black is actually threatening to take on h2. For instance, if something like this, then this move is good for black, because after this move you have this move and you can't really go out, and you can't really stay in, so something like this is just very bad. The bishop is trapped and the king is in serious trouble. Probably it will have to try and run very fast away from the line of fire. But this is actually a very critical position here. Reiner played this move, which is a very natural move, but maybe not the best move. Instead, the computer suggests this move, which looked like a mistake, because this bishop was supposed to go here without having this. But at the moment, actually, white is probably better, because the refutation, if you might say, g5 does not really work after this move and take and this line here. The weakness on here and here, I'll make them red instead, is very serious, and even though black can win a pawn here, after something like this, white is much better at this moment, and I don't really see how black can do. This move is interesting, and here, for instance, after something like this, probably this is fine for black, but instead of rook f2, you can go knight e5, and just opening the center, leaving this rook in. Black is threatening to. White is threatening to take the bishop, play queen f2 with a double attack on the bishop and the knight. And I don't see a real good defense for black here. He's gonna lose the exchange, and it's. It's really not easy to defend something like this. So this looks like a problem for black. H3, I'm thinking, and white's idea is simply to go back here. And if black cannot get rid of the pin with d5, and probably have to play something like this, then white will come with knight e5, f4, and get an excellent Filsbury structure. If you don't know what the Filsbury is, you should definitely check out the other videos on the Carlsbad structure, where this is explained rather thoroughly. So instead, he played this move. So this move is probably very critical, simply threatening to play something like this, and getting the rook here, and maybe e4 and so on. And white will get pretty good attacking chances, I guess. The pin is annoying, and if you can't play d5 due to the upcoming weakness in the their file, it's not really good. So black will have to find something else here. Maybe bishop d4 is not a good idea, but anyway, then black will just play h3 and so on. So it's, I don't know, not so simple. Anyway, he played bishop d3, took, and knight d4. I'm not sure that's completely accurate, but it makes sense. Black is putting a knight here where it can't really be moved, and maybe trading some like this, but it could also be trading something like this. And it's annoying to have a knight near your king like this, and we see that this structure is not really great for white here. Rook here looks a little bit weird, but he's preparing this move, protecting this one, protecting this one, getting ready for this move, and later on this move. But the problem is, even if you take on e4 and white takes back, then this square will be weak, and this double pawn will look stupid. H5 is a strong move by Mogens, who gets ready to put the knight on this square, which does not look like a great square, but from here it controls these two squares that are very important for this situation here. So f3, knight e6, queen f2, white is ready for this move now. Knight gets back, I'm getting into the game. E4, queen d6, I'm not sure I like this queen d6, it looks, it does pin the bishop, but it's also, I don't know, maybe white can play something like this move here, and be better, and play next on this here, and he's just gonna take with the bishop and push d5, and probably be having some sort of an attack, or maybe knight can go, and here, knight here is usually very strong in these situations. Instead, Reiner did something that was definitely wrong. He played this move, and that's just, I hope nobody gets offended here, but that's a kind of problem with getting older. These are the plus 65 category, and whenever I am, I'm also, for some of you probably know, I'm also a newspaper columnist. I write a daily column in the Danish, two Danish newspapers, Jyllandsposten and Politiken, and I'm always trying to find some good games with the seniors, and it's always a problem because they tend to play too passively. It's something that just happens when you get older. You just start to, and I can see it for myself, I'm starting to put my pieces on passive squares, and this kind of move, it's just, you can just feel, no, this cannot be right, come on, you, this move, what is that? So that's and even a rather aggressive, active player like Reiner makes this mistake, and it's a bit of a shame. So black takes, and the thing is, you don't really want a knight here. That's something you really don't want. You play here, and here you still don't want it, and now you definitely don't want it, because this pawn will be lost. So he took with the bishop, which was definitely not the point. It's not a disaster yet, it's fine. White is okay, but it's just that it's clear that knight e2 is an old man's move. Sorry, Reiner. H4. Nice little move. It was threatened, and instead of defending it, which you could do, black goes on to weaken white's dark squares, and take, and here, and white is probably okay here. And c5, and that's kind of nice. There's a pin here. This knight is not able to join the game at the moment, but it will be later. And this square, of course, is important. D5, and knight d4. All very good. Threaten all kind of things here. So you'll have to do something. And he took it, and of course you're not gonna lose a pawn by taking back. So he takes here and attacks the knight and go back. And we have a sort of a tense situation here, which is probably rather equal. I think white should play knight c3. Instead, Reiner thinks he has all the time in the world and plays a4, which is luxury move in a sharp battle, and this is nice game move by Mogens Thuesen, simply getting ready to attack in the e-file. Knight comes here anyway, and white is of course hoping to sit on the blacks, on the white squares, with something here and so on, but it is and this is also normal. Interesting move, take, and here And here he definitely makes a mistake, Reiner. He plays this move, and it looks natural, but it's dangerous. I think actually Black's best move might be this move, but he goes to g6, and is probably threatening this move, which could be rather unpleasant. But White should just play this, and on this move just play something like this, and I think he's okay. He played this move, which is a clear mistake, and now it gets ugly really fast. Oops, that hurt. The threat is very simple, knight here, and of course there might also be knight here, but it's not completely clear. But knight here is definitely a problem, and I think what Reiner missed was this move, and boom, what a problem. Threatening the queen, it's covered by this one and this one, so black is so white is in serious trouble now. Black is very active and also have a nice structure and so on, and this is of course coming, and this loses by force, five, and you could resign here, and here is black to move, and I will give you 1 minute to consider black's options, to see if you can solve this situation. Mogens did it rather well. He found the solution, and to the Danish chess site, he wrote that it was only his second win in his life against a grandmaster. So congratulations to Mogens on this great game, which also had happened to be of great theoretical interest for the Carlsbad structure. Yeah, you probably guessed that this is a good move, and this is the problem. Check, and we see that there's no solving this. And after this, white resigned. He's gonna lose this pawn, and it's gonna be two pawns behind. And well, this moment can definitely win for sure. So Reiner gave up. So we are back at the drawing board for black regarding a line against the card, the exchange variation for black, because I'm not sure I like this bishop d6 if white goes knight f3 and later on h3 and is not afraid of d5. Anyway, this was GM Talks with another video. Remember, you can